Hey guys, it's Desi. Welcome back to my channel. So if you guys watched my last video, you will know exactly what this video is. But if you have not watched it, this video is going to be a full review on the brand new Pretty Fresh foundation by ColourPop. So if you guys want to hear my opinion on the foundation and want to see how I achieved this full face look, then go ahead and keep watching. Okay, so first, before we get started, I am going to be priming my face with the Touch and Soul Glassy Pretty Filter Glassy Skin Balm. This is what it looks like. I remember the first time that I opened it, I was like, what the hell? Like, I turned it over and opened it this way because that's the way things open. Like, the lid is always thinner than the body of the whole thing. But no. This part is the lid. So first I'm going to be applying this to my face as primer. And this primer, I don't know if it's a lotion or a primer to be quite honest. Like it doesn't specifically say on there face primer, but it makes my skin feel so amazing and so like soft and dewy, and it's not like oily or greasy or anything. Honestly, Touch and Soul has really awesome products. I use their poreless primer on myself and all my clients literally all the time. It just has such an amazing finish. So now, what you all came here for, the brand new Pretty Fresh foundation by ColourPop. Let me just say, first impressions, I'm loving it. The box is literally so sleek. Like the pictures on it are so simple. It has like how to put it on, what's so special about it, and the box is just such a sleek look. So it is dermatologist tested, oil free, and vegan, which is also a really big thing for me. It has hyaluronic acid in it, which is known like to help fight pimples and keep skin like very hydrated. It is for all skin types, and it also has coconut water in there. And it is medium buildable coverage for natural, healthy looking skin. So as of right now, I'm kind of getting the vibe that if you do need like very heavy, full coverage, this wouldn't be the foundation for you. And then it says you can prep your skin with the Pretty Fresh Primer and the Pretty Fresh Blending Sponge, which I did try to get both, but at Ulta they were sold out. I did go to Ulta to buy this because it came out online a few days ago, but I didn't want to wait for the shipping. So the day it came out at Ulta, I did go and buy it at Ulta. My only thing was Ulta didn't have every single shade range. And also right now, like due to coronavirus and everything that's going on, you couldn't really swatch it. So I literally had to go off the picture and try and find my shade. ColourPop did post a picture, which is this one right here. And I did want to get 125N, but unfortunately, like I said, Ulta didn't have the full shade range. So I did go for 120W. I am nervous to try it out because he does have a little bit more of a yellowish tint than I do. My tint is more peachy, which is why I was trying to go with the 125N, but we will see. So like before, I really do like the packaging. It's very nice and sleek, straight to the point. I do like that it is plastic because I do have a lot of, is it? I can't tell if it is glass or plastic. It feels plasticky to me, but it could be glass. Like I am kind of second guessing it now, but hopefully it's plastic, because what I was gonna say is most foundations are glass packaging and I do have a habit of dropping them, and my floor is tile, so they do shatter. That's what glass does. So I'm hoping this one is plastic. I'm pretty sure I'll be finding out later. So let's just get into it. My skin is already primed, and as you guys can see, that primer is very dewy. It does leave like a glassy skin look. One thing that I do not like is that it is a pump foundation. Me personally, I just don't like those. I do prefer droppers. If you guys watch my videos normally, you know that I do use my Dior one, and that one is a dropper just because the application is a lot easier. These, like, you either have to pump onto the skin or onto the brush or the sponge. And I personally just don't like doing that. I feel like you lose a lot of product, or it either makes like a mess of the pump. But that's just my personal opinion. Okay, so I am gonna be applying it two different ways for you guys. I'm gonna be showing you all how it applies using a brush and how it applies using a sponge. Different foundations do apply differently, so we're gonna see which one works better. In case you guys do wanna buy it, you know what to use it with. So this side, I'm going to be using my sponge. This is a Real Techniques sponge, and I do wanna give a lot of credit to Real Techniques for this sponge, because before this video, this was covered in foundation, and I went to wash it, and look, y'all, it literally all came off. I'm shook. So I'm gonna squeeze some on to the sponge. I can already see right now, I'm scared. This looks a little bit too dark for me. Guys, so I can already see now, it does look a little bit too orange toned. Okay. It does look a little bit too orangey. That's okay. I'm literally doing this for the purpose of you guys being able to see how this foundation works. So I know now that it does not perfectly match. Do not come for me. And it sucks that I can't go return it, because obviously right now they're not gonna do returns. But it is what it is. I mean, it's not that big of a difference. I can already say now, this foundation does feel extremely dewy, but I also did put on a dewy primer, but I'm kind of liking it because lately I've been dealing with dry skin, and I did like the way that it applied with the sponge. I did use very little, and it did spread out through my entire face. So that's good, because you don't have to reapply and reapply and reapply. A little bit does go a long way with this foundation. And it does feel very lightweight on my skin. I am liking the way it feels. I don't feel cakey yet. Once I apply my bronzer and everything, I will be able to tell a little better. So this time I'm gonna apply it straight to my face. And I am going to be using a flat foundation brush to apply it. This is just a regular Beauty Creations brush. And I can already say right now, I do like how the brush is applying it better. It's spreading it a little bit more evenly for me. Y'all, I am orange, orange. This shade is definitely not my shade. Look at how orange I look.
But your makeup looks really good.
So, foundation is on. I did favor the brush application over the beauty blender application. So now I'm going to be applying my concealer. I'm using my go-to concealer, which is the Dior Skin Forever Concealer. I'm just gonna be applying it how I normally do. So I'm gonna be using my flat brush and just spreading it. And now I'm gonna be going in with my Hank and Henry beauty sponge and blending it all. And now going in with the Ciate London Everyday Vacay Powder. I'm going to be setting my under eyes, and I'm also going to be setting my entire face. And I'm using a Real Techniques powder sponge to set my under eyes, just so that it really gets just packed in there really well. And now using this Aesthetica Cosmetics brush, I'm going to dip a little bit of the powder onto the brush and just sweeping it across my entire face, just so that I don't become too dewy throughout the day. And I don't want to become oily. Even though I do have dry skin, this foundation is very dewy. I can feel it sitting on my skin. I feel like I'm sweating. But just because I usually don't wear dewy foundation, I'm not really used to it. And this is also just to give me an airbrushed finish. And it could just be me being hot because I am sitting in, I am sitting in front of an entire setup of studio lights. So that's more than likely what it is. So now to bronze my face, I'm going to be using the BH Cosmetics Brilliance Bronzer. This one is in the shade Bronze Babe, and I'm just gonna be taking it on my go-to Alamar Cosmetics bronzer brush. I'm just gonna be packing it under my cheekbone. I'm gonna be adding very little to my forehead. And now for blush, I'm going to be using the Ciate London Marbled Light Blush. This one is in the shade Dusk, and this is what it looks like. It does have a little bit of a shimmer to it. I'm applying it to the apples of my cheeks. And this is just like my everyday products that I do use. And next, I have literally been obsessed with this highlighter. If you have been watching my recent videos, you know that I have been using this highlighter in every single video that I have been doing. I literally cannot stop using this highlighter. It is the Tom Ford Sheer Highlighting Duo, and it is just the most gorgeous highlighter I have seen in my entire life. I took a small break to go eat because I was literally starving. So that gave my eyes some really good time to set. And honestly, I do like the way that the foundation did set. It doesn't look so orange like at all anymore. It oxidized really nicely and actually oxidized more to color, which I think is a very impressive thing to do, because usually when foundations dry, they oxidize like more orangey and like a different color than what they look like when they were put on. So this one's kind of the opposite of that, which I really, really like. Okay, so now for lips, I'm going to be going in with this lip liner right here. It is in the shade Cozy Kira by Beauty Vault. This is what it looks like. And then for lipstick, I'm going to be using the Morphe Brushes lipstick. This is in the shade Kissy Face. I honestly will forever love the Morphe Brushes lipstick packaging. And I'm just gonna be blotting this one on. This lip combo is literally my fave. I have so many favorite lip combos. I literally want to make an entire video like just showing you guys my favorite nude lip combos. Let me know what you guys would think about that, because so now I'm just going to be finishing my under eyes, which if you've already seen my last video is in my last video. It's kind of like I'm time traveling, like going backwards, and you know. And I will be back to set the rest of my face and give you guys my final opinion on the Pretty Fresh foundation. Okay guys, I already finished my eyes. Now I'm just gonna be setting my face. And to do that, I'm going to be using the LA Girl setting spray. I'm literally so obsessed with this setting spray. The smell is so amazing and it just feels so good on my skin. So overall, my full 100% honest opinion on the foundation, I would give it like an 8 out of 10. I honestly really, really do like it. It feels very nice on my face. It's very lightweight. It is more full coverage. I didn't get cakey with the powder. Overall, I just really like this foundation. Personally, I prefer a matte foundation over a dewy foundation, but this foundation does not feel like nasty and wet. So yes, I definitely do recommend this foundation if you all want to give it a try. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up and comment down below what you guys thought. And if you do want to see the full eye look on this eye look, it'll be linked down in the description. go ahead and give it a watch. You guys will not regret it. And also head over to my Instagram and give me a follow. And I will see you guys in my next video.